got this Primora screen now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, okay. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
In the last class, we have studied about this resources part. How many of you guys, hope all of you practice this one, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, okay. In that, we have seen some of the resources, how we can add resources and how we can assign resources and how we can organize the resources. Now we can see two major topics in this, that is resource usage profile and resource usage spreadsheet. That is, now in this project what we are having, see, we are having this project here. This is a simple project that what we were discussing in the last session. Now, we want this resource usage profile or spreadsheet. That is, how optimally the resources are using in this project. That is, do we have any over allocation? That is, if the manpower is that we are having is 8 members, consider the requirement is 12 members. What will be the over allocation part? Resources that we are having is 8 members and the requirement is 12 members. What will be the overall allocation part?
20.
Four members, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, that's the thing. See, here to get this resource usage profile, just go to view in the menu bar. In that, show on bottom, resource usage profile. Got it? Got it? Or do you want me to repeat?
Please, one second.
Okay, okay. See, I have opened this project. After opening the project, what I'll do is I'll just move to the one of the activity and I'll go to this view, show on bottom. Everyone got it? Show on bottom and resource usage profile in that. Now we got the resource usage profile in the bottom. Okay. Got it? That is, okay. We can get a profile in histogram. That is, this is called as histogram part, where we can get individual activities profile. How much resources are used in the each and every activity. That is, see, in excavation part, we are using JCB. Steel, site engineer. In the total project, how much resources that we are using, that we can get here. See, this is the profile what we are getting here. The entire profile shows a graph, pictorial representation of resource usage. See, now if you want to see in numbers, go to view, show on bottom, resource usage spreadsheet. Now we got the same thing. See, that here the date is September 6th to September 13th. Next, September 13th to September 20th. That is 8 days gap will be there. Got it?
Okay, sir.
Got it? This is resource usage profile and resource usage spreadsheet. Got it? It's a simple thing, no need to scribble your head much. Okay. Now, the next topic what we want to discuss is WPS and document. That is, work progress and documents. This is very important because it's very difficult to mail a document above 20 MB, right? In Gmail, as you all know. What's the maximum capacity that we can mail?
15 MB.
Pardon me?
15 MB.
I hope it's 20. Whatever it may be, 15 okay. to 20, 15 to 20 MB. See, now in this work progress and documents, what we are having, what I'll do is, I'll just right click, what is this work products and documents? This is where we can store the document, and where we can store and share the document for distance viewing. Consider someone in the same project that I am the designer sitting in this Karnataka. One more designer is sitting in Gulf, that is Abu Dhabi. See, I want to share my document and my progress to him without a mail. Are you getting my words?
Yes, sir.
I want to share the things without a mail. See, what I'll do is, I'll add one activity over here. See, the document is with respect to foundation part. Foundation part. And the reference number is FX001. And the status is in progress. I want to show the progress. And I want to show the job photos here. See, this is the work product, what I am specifying here. And this general part, the title is, foundation. Reference number is APEC001, version 1, job photos document category. Status is work progress. Revision date is today's date. Okay. Next, coming to description, I can give some description for this. What's the description? Still, the foundation is in progress. We have short call of manpower to complete the task in the time. This is the description what I am giving, and the work complete is is 60%. This is the description for that, and I want to check the location. I want to give one document because we are in delay of this completion of this foundation part and all. I want to attach one document. What I'll do is I have one document that is called appreciation letter. I'll open this. This is a document, sample document I am attaching. Open. See, I have stored one document in my system. This is consider this as a cloud. I have attached this one for this, for the reference part. Consider we are having a photos of the site, job photos of the site in this document. Okay, this is a private location. Assignment, if I want to assign the activity, this is with respect to foundation, right? I have attached this. See, I have completed this work product and document category. Right? Got it?
Mm-hmm. Sir.
Everyone got it?
Okay,
everyone,
sir.
Okay. Or do you want me to repeat once again this part?
Okay, sir.
You want me to repeat?
No, sir. No, sir. Yes, sir.
Do you want me to repeat this one?
No, sir.
No, sir. No, sir.
Okay. See, now we have done everything in work products and documents. So, I want to visualize this document. I have completed this work in work products and documents. I will go to project now. See, in this general tab, in the below settings, what I'll do is I'll open the project. In this project, I have updated this one. See, here we'll be having work products and documents. See, in this we have foundation progress. If you go for the details, The entire detail is showing here. I have appreciation, the private location, what, where I have shared, which I have shared. I got this one here. If I want to launch this, go to launch. I got the appreciation. If I have added any other document related to this, so that it is easy, very easy to open in this process, where we will be sharing the entire documents in a cloud, so that each and individual candidate in the project team, so that they will be easy access for each and every document of the respective projects. Got it?
Okay, sir.
Got it? I'll okay, close sir. This one.
Yes, sir.
Okay. See, this is all about work product and documents. Next, we will go for this currency validation. What is currency validation? Any idea?
Which currency that we are using?
Yes, correct. See, in this project, consider if I want to do the same project in US. Okay, what's the currency of US?
Dollars.
I want to assign that currency to my project. What I'll do is user preferences, go to currency. I want to go for US dollars. Close. See, for my project, the currency allotted is dollars. Got it? Everyone getting here?
Yes, sir.
Is it visible?
Yes, sir.
See, okay. See, in the same manner, if I want to change the currency to any other thing, okay, I'll go for Canadian dollar. Okay, close. I got the Canadian dollar here. If I want to change it for Indian rupees, go to edit preference, user preferences. That is INR. Close. Got it?
Okay.
Okay. Now we have a default currencies here. That is, you got USD, you got Canadian dollars, you got Indian rupees. In case, if you want to generate your own currency, we want to build our own currency. See, in those cases, what we can do is go to admin, currencies. What we can do, here we have all the things. You can change the symbol also, you can change the exchange rate also, because usually this exchange rates will be fluctuating, as you also know, according to the market, right?
Okay.
Sir.
Here we can add one more currency. See, I'll give the currency name as Apex, and the currency name, currency ID Apex, and currency name Apex 001. And the symbol I'll give hash symbol for my currency, and the exchange rate is 40 rupees of Apex. Okay, enter, close. See, in this case, what I'll do is, if I want to change my cost currency as my Apex, edit user preferences, go to currency. Here I'll be having a search for Apex, APEX. You got it right, Apex. And we got the currency also. See, here we got the exchange rate. Everyone got it?
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Got it? Yes, I hope you can do this now.
Yes, sir.
I'll change it to Indian rupees. Close. Got it?
Okay, sir.
Okay, clear?
Yes, sir.
Clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Someone texted me in WhatsApp regarding the reports and all. You know who is that?
Me, sir.
Sitharan.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Have you completed the report? Up to what extent you have completed?
Up to resources I completed, sir.
Okay. You just share your report in a PDF or Word copy so that I'll check it. and reward you. Okay, I have shared this resources as well as billing items sheets in WhatsApp group. I hope so in the morning.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Everyone got it. I hope it will be useful for you guys to select the resources and add in your project.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Rashmi, up to what extent you have completed?
Sir, I think in painting, sir, specification.
You can if you want to copy the specification sheet, you can copy from the Word document.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, you can do that. But coming to this project, what I gave you, this Krishnappa project and all, you just write in your own words so that it will be helpful. And starting projects, what you have explained in detail, that is from critical path metadata, AON diagrams, and some other basic project that we have discussed, so that you put those projects in your own words.
Okay, sir.
Okay. I hope your internship report must be around 30 to 40 pages. We have completed this currency validation yet. Next, coming to the reports, this activity usage reports and the 2 week look ahead reports, to get those reports, and you have to paste those report in your internship report also. See, here we have a third icon called reports. Go to the reports. Here you will be having in detail reports of your project. Any of the project, you can get this report. That is considered AD1 report. What is this AD1 report? That is, you have plenty of reports. I'll take an example of two reports. That is activity status report and 2 week look ahead report. See, what is this report? Activity status report. To open this report, what you have to do is activity status report, run report, print preview. Okay. Everyone got this?
Yes.
This is a simple report.
Yes, sir.
Of your activity status. See, in this activity status report, you'll be having activity ID, activity name, original duration of your activity, and remaining duration of your project. Activity completed, okay. And primary resources for your activity. Early started, early finish of your activity. Got it?
Okay, sir.
You'll be getting entire description of your activity in single report. See, we are having only 5 activities in our project, simple project. If not, I'll go to one complicated project. See, in this innovation. See, in this project, we'll go for reports. Activity status report. Run report. It'll take some time. Got it? Got it? It is a project which have been completed. See, in this also we have activity ID, activity name, original duration, remaining duration, percentage of the completion, primary resource, early start and early finish. See, this is complete activity report, activity name and primary resources that we'll be having. See, this is a complicated and this is a lengthy project that we have. In this, see how these activities are arranged in a sequential manner. This is a sample report so that after completing your report, after completing your project, you can get each and individual reports like this. Got it? Where you will get reports? That is the third icon. Reports, go to the individual activity report that you want, right click and run report. Got it? Got it?
Okay, sir.
Okay. Now see.
Okay, sir.
Let me pause it. See, in this project, I have budgeted total cost. If I want to add columns, that is, if I want individual material, non-material, and labor cost, I want to right-click on this, go to columns. Here, you'll be having a cost drop-down in which you'll be getting budgeted labor cost, budgeted material cost, and budgeted non-labor cost. Okay, I have added these three things here. Go to OK. These columns in the selected option will appear in your screen if I give OK. See, now I have budgeted labor cost, budgeted material cost, budgeted non-labor cost. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Combinedly, it will go for budgeted total cost. This is individual breakup because we must know how much we want to invest on labor, how much we want to invest on material, and how much we want to invest on non-labor. Got it?
Okay, sir.
Got it? Or else, these number of columns are getting more in our pay. If I want to delete those, select this one, go to backward menu, backward direction arrow. Okay. Those are deleted. Got it? How to add and delete?
Yes, sir.
Got it? Everyone got it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. See, these are very important topics that we have discussed now. Resource usage profile, resource usage spreadsheet, work product and documents. Next, what we have discussed?